It was a snowy winter evening. The snow was heavy and covered the island. Edward was at the China clay pits. He was collecting the train to bring to the docks before returning to the shed. The snow was beginning to fall when he arrived. While he was waiting to be coupled up, he heard Bill and Ben coming towards him.
Hey Edward, what are you doing here?
Yeah, isn't it past your bedtime?
I still have a train to take to the docks. It needs to get to the ship before it leaves.
But why you?
Could have brought the train ourselves.
Ben is right. We brought trains to the docks before, whatever the weather.
I don't know, to be exact. I guess they were worried you would have an accident.
We were not.
Before Edward could reply, the snow fell harder and the wind blew. The engines couldn't see an inch past their buffers. Just then, the manager showed up. He had news.
The weather has turned for the worse. The Fat Controller orders all engines to remain in their sheds until further notice. The same goes for all ships at Brendam Docks. Edward, you'll have to stay here until the weather clears.
Yes, sir.
I've never seen snow like this before.
Yeah, this must be the worst the island has experienced.
Well, it's definitely bad weather, but not the worst. The worst snow this island faced was more than it is now.
Really?
Can you tell us what it was like?
Yeah, it's not like we are going anywhere soon, so we might as well listen to a story.
Very well. Let me tell you about the big freeze of 1955.
Isn't that the title of the video?
Shh!
It was a winter unlike any other. It happened just around the time Duck became part of the railway. Snow had hit the island hard. Many trains were delayed, and a few lines had to close. As a result of this, we had to take part in clearing the tracks with our snowplows. It was also at this time that James was at the works, after an accident he had down Gordon's Hill. So the Fat Controller had called Winston back to fill in for him while he was gone. It was nice to see him again after so many years, and he was glad to be back.
I heard about him. Didn't he help build the railway when he was starting out?
Indeed he did, along with a few other engines.
Henry told us about them. Heard two of them were very rude to work with. They wouldn't dare play tricks on us.
I'd hate to see those two tangle with you twins. Anyway, we did our work as best as we could, but every night it would continue to snow, harder and harder, making it more and more difficult. We were in the sheds one night talking about the day's work. Everyone was red in the face and tired.
I tell you, if this snow gets worse, we'll be lucky to open the shed doors tomorrow.
I'm tired of it. I'm gonna have so much mail to deliver by the time the snow melts. I can barely do any work without running into a snowdrift.
The yards are a mess because all the trucks and coaches need to be dug out before they can be arranged.
Pah! You little engines don't know how lucky you are. Us bigger engines are having the most difficulty with the snow. I can't even climb the hill with my express because the rails are covered in ice, even with Edward pushing from behind. I can't run my train at high speeds in this weather, which means I can't run my trains to time.
I agree, Gordon. The snow makes it difficult for me to pull my heavy goods trains. I spend more time trying to grip the rails than I do going anywhere.
Calm down, you two. We all have our work cut out for us, especially in this weather. It's not like it is during the warmer seasons.
That may be, Edward. But us bigger engines are having the worst time coping with our normal duties with this foul weather, while the tankage is just playing in the snow.
Playing, Gordon? Well, if that's how you feel, Percy and I can go back to the branch line and watch a galloping sausage like you shunt your own train.
Ooh, I have never been so insulted.
Never mind, Gordon. We all know this weather isn't exactly ideal for our work.
You're right, Edward. All we can do is the best we can. At least the trains aren't running at night. That's even more dangerous than during the day.
How long has the jury been out? It's only been a half hour now.
Since we shouldn't worry about that, we should all get some sleep and be ready for what tomorrow brings.
Although none of us were scheduled to pull trains at night, that didn't stop engines from the other railway. One such engine was struggling with a goods train meant for Brandon Docks. It was late at night, and the wind howled and blew snow in every direction. The engine couldn't see an inch past his buckles, and neither could the crew. It was just like Winston said, any train at night in a blizzard is dangerous work. That didn't stop the engine, though. What did stop him was a snowdrift. It was right in front of him, and he couldn't see it until he crashed right into it. He was stuck in the snow and couldn't get out. His crew and the guard tried to dig him out, but to no avail. So they put out the engine's fire and waited in the brake van until morning to call for help. When morning broke, the engine was covered in snow, all the way to his boiler. The crew went and put detonators along the track, then walked to the nearest station. By the time they arrived, the snow began to fall again. The station master called the Fat Controller, and he made his way to the sheds and dock.
All right, everyone, we have an emergency. There is an engine who was traveling from the mainland with the goods train that was meant to be brought to Brendan Docks. Due to the weather last night, he is stuck in the snow, along with his crew and goods train, out on the main line.
Oh dear, how awful.
That poor engine must be frozen to the frames.
Goodness gracious, how can any engine be foolish enough to go in such dreadful weather at night? It's simply not safe.
That's not important right now, Gordon. What is important is that the engine needs our help, or he'll have to wait until spring to thaw out.
Thomas is quite right. We are organizing a rescue team to save the engine, its crew, and its train. Duck has volunteered, but we need at least one more engine to help.
I can't, sir. What will the passengers do without the Premier Express engine pulling the train?
I'll hope, sir. No engine should be out in this weather.
Are you sure, Winston? It seems like demanding work.
I'm sure, Henry. Duck and I can handle the snow.
I'll help too, sir. The three of us will make short work of this.
That's what I like to hear! Okay then, Duck, Winston and Edward, make your way to the fitter's yard and collect a snow plow and a coach for the workmen. No doubt there will be a lot of shoveling to do. The rest of you, do your work as best you can. Be careful out there. The snow is going to start again later, and we can't risk any more engines getting stuck.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So we made our way to the fitter's yard. The snowplow was fitted onto Winston's front, I was coupled behind him, and coupled to an old coach, with Duck at the rear. Workmen piled into the coach with shovels and sand. As we puffed out of the yards, the snow had completely covered the tracks, but that didn't stop us. The three of us pushed hard to clear the lines as we went to rescue the engine and its train. It was slow and steady work, but there were some areas that needed to be dug out, so the workmen, with their shovels, dug as much as they could and would spread hot coals from our fires to help melt the snow away. It wasn't long, though, until we made our way to a very peculiar-looking snowdrift.
What's that?
Everything all right up there, Winston?
That snowbank in front of us is huge. I think it's... It is!
We came up to find the snowdrift was the engine we were looking for. He looked like he was frozen to the frames.
Are you alright?
I've seen better days. Especially when I'm not stuck in the snow.
Are you damaged in any way?
No, I just can't move. My joints... bearings are frozen.
Oh dear.
Don't worry, we'll have you out soon.
Thank you.
It was difficult trying to get the engine out of all the snow. The men worked hard digging with the wind blowing in their faces. It's one thing when an engine is stuck in a snowbank, and another when it's stuck with a warm boiler. It melts away at the snow, and when the boiler cools, the melted snow freezes all over, turning the cylinders and joints into blocks of ice. The workmen had to set fire to some pieces of torn cloth and sprinkle hot coals from fireboxes over the ice to make it melt. It was a long and difficult job. By the time the engine was nearly clear of the snow, Winston and I coupled up and pulled him out of the bank. He was finally free and resembled an engine and not an igloo. I took the frozen chap to the works while Winston and Doug stayed behind to get the train out.
Are you ready, Doc?
Yes, I'm ready.
They got the train out and together brought it to the docks. I made it to Groven's Gate Works just as James was puffing out, fully repaired. As I shunted him into a siding, I had a moment to speak to the engine before returning home. You must be cold after being stuck in that snowdrift.
Yes, it's not something I want to go through twice.
Thomas got stuck in a snowdrift once. Silly soft stuff, it won't stop me, he said. Needed a tractor to get him unstuck.
I probably would have thought of that too if I didn't get buried by the stuff.
Why would your controller want you to pull a train at night in a snowstorm?
It needed to go to Burnham Docks, because the docks and barrow were closed due to the snow? Achoo!
Bless you. Well, once your fire is lit and you've been checked over, you should be able to return home soon.
I'll only go if I can borrow a snowplow, so I don't get stuck again.
It was a few days before the engine was cleared to depart back to his own railway. Winston had left too, once James was back in service. I haven't seen snow like that for a while, but you never know. To this day, Winston works here and so does the engine I mentioned. His name is Barry, and he works on the Harwick branch line with Ryan and Daisy.
So they both work here now?
Yes, they do.
But how did Barry end up coming here? And Winston too?
I'm afraid that's a story for another day. For now, we should get some sleep.
That morning, the snow hadn't stopped, and Edward was given the okay to bring the china clay to the docks. As he was puffing along, he saw a large mound of snow. When he got closer, he saw Thomas in the mound, and Percy was trying to pull him out.
Thomas, Percy, what happened?
Thomas and I were taking a small test ride to Burnham Docks, but the points froze and Thomas crashed into the snow.
I hate snow. I want to get out, please.
Just then, Barry popped up alongside. He was surprised.
Hello, Percy, Edward, Thomas? What happened to you?
We were bringing a goods train to the docks. But the points had frozen, and I crashed and now I'm stuck.
Well, I've been there before. Here, let me help you out.
So Barry was coupled up to Percy, and the two engines pulled Thomas out of the snow. Thomas was relieved.
Thank you for getting me out.
No problem.
Just like old times, huh, Barry?
Too much like old times, Edward. Too much like old times.